This is the Sabercat Report with Saguaro Sabercat football coach Jason Mons on the Varsity Sports Show, AM 1060 KDUS Arizona. And now, here's Coach Mons. Welcome back to the Varsity Sports Show here on AM 1060 KDUS Arizona. Wow. Close one last night, but came away with a victory. That was Saguaro Sabercats over the ALA Queen Creek Patriots. Joining us on the line, Sabercats head football coach Jason Mons and analyst Ryan Sikora. Gentlemen, good morning.
Morning, guys.
All right, morning, Coach Mons, let us have it.
Well, I think everybody in Arizona, including our kids, didn't think we were going to get the game we got last night, even though we tried to tell them. And show them, but you know, first off, all the credit to ALA Queen Creek. They are a good football team. They're well coached. They played pretty much mistake free football. They had one deflected pass that we picked off, but that, you know, I thought they came out and they just executed their game plan flawlessly. They tackled well. They played physical. They absolutely played their tails off. They kept the ball away from us. They converted third downs and fourth downs, and then we made a bunch of mistakes and we shot ourselves in the foot. And When you play a good football team that plays disciplined and physical and mistake-free and you make a bunch of mistakes, then you allow teams to stay in the game. And the longer you allow a team like that to believe in themselves, then the more of a dogfight you have on your hands. And that's what we had last night. So credit to our kids, though. They responded when they needed to, and we made some plays down the stretch. And, you know, we, I think, had maybe a little false sense of where we were as a team after our scrimmage in the first game. And I think now we realize that we got a long way to go.
Coach, you know, I got to tell you, that Logan Hubler, that quarterback number 15 for the Patriots, that guy reminded me of a combination of Ty Detmer and Max Hall, and it turns out that those are his coaches. So, I mean, is that what you saw on film when you were scouting this kid?
Yeah, you know, I think he's the state 300-meter hurdle champion. I mean, the kid's a phenomenal athlete. And, you know, the thing that shows up on film, and I watched a ton of film of them, I think the one thing I want you guys to know is from a preparation standpoint, from a coaching staff, we didn't take them lightly. We thought that they did some really good things, and we thought that kid was a phenomenal player, super athletic. You know, he doesn't look, I mean, like, we obviously, you know, we have Ridge, and Ridge is, you know, almost 6'3", and, you know, 215 pounds, and Ridge looks like a Division I quarterback. You know, the Hubler kid is kind of wiry and skinny, but, man, he's a football player. He's competitive. You know, doesn't throw the prototypical the football, but he gets it to where it needs to go on time, and he can sure make plays with his legs. And I just thought he competed. I thought he left it all on the field. I thought that entire team did. They came out. They you know, a lot of teams show up, they get off the bus, and they step on the field, and they kind of get overwhelmed. And those kids didn't. They were ready to go. And I think it started with the quarterback.
And Coach, you mentioned you do your research, and you do that for every team. And I did my research for this game as well. And when you looked at it, ALA stood out offensively on the ball. But when you watched the game last night, really what made them competitive last night was their defensive effort. Can you talk about that and if that surprised you at all?
Yeah, well, I just stepped out of watching grading film right now with the offensive staff. And I think if you look at it, you know, and they did, listen, they lined up and they tackled and they didn't give us, you know, they kind of played bend but don't break. But really, the struggles that we had offensively were self-inflicted wounds. I mean, we had penalties, we had drop balls, we had fumbles, we had missed blocking assignments. I mean, I think what we wanted to do was there. We just didn't do it and didn't execute it. So, and some of that's credit to them. They did some good stuff up front with some stunts and giving us some looks, stuff that they hadn't put on film at all. I think they got their hands on some film of some teams that have had success against our zone running game, and they did some really good stuff that they had not shown over the course of the last three seasons. And so credit them. But I really think, I mean, when we watched this film with our kids, I think if we executed the way we were supposed to, we probably left about 28 points on the board.
Well, Coach, congratulations once again on the win, 2-0. You come away with a victory last night over ALA Queen Creek, the Patriots, 20-14. You got a bye week this week. Then you've got the test. You've got Chaparral. You're heading over to their place, and I'm sure you're going to be watching a lot of film the next couple of weeks and getting your coaches out there scouting. So good luck. Congratulations, and we'll circle back with you next week.
All right, guys. Thanks a lot.
All right. Ryan, thanks again for joining, and we'll talk to you next week, bud.
Thank you for having me, Vince.